Hello students, in the last video we have started chapter 9, India, Location and Extent, in which you have learned three subtopics, that was location, size and political division. And the last one left is physiographic divisions of India. So today we will read this subtopic. On the basis of tectonic history, India may be divided into the following physiographic divisions. Now, first of all, we have to read the division, that is the northern mountains. They stretch across northern India from Jammu and Kashmir to Arunachal Pradesh with a varying width of 240 to 320 kilometers, forming the Himalayas in the east-west direction, and its offshoots run in north-south direction along the India-Myanmar boundary, traversing through Nagaland, Manipur and Mizoram, known as Eastern Hills. And they represent the youngest and highest folded mountains of the earth, formed by the tectonic collision of the Indian Plateau with the Eurasian Plateau. Now, next is longitudinally, the Himalayas consist of four parallel ranges from south to north. Now, in this we have to see the first one is the outer Himalayas, that is Shivalik. We can call that Shivalik also. And it is almost continuous range of low hills composed of unconsolidated territory. Sediments emerged as the most recent phase in Himalaya orogeny. And the second one is the lesser Himalayas, that we can call as the Himachal. And it generally consists of unfossiferous sediments of metamorphosed crystalline. And important ranges include the Dholadhar, Pir Panjal, Nagtiba, Mahabharat and Masuri range. And the third one is the Greater Himalayas, we can call as the Himadri also. And it is the most continuous, loftiest and northernmost range of the Himalayas. It has a core of Archean granites and gneisses and schist rocks. This range contains one of the highest mountain peaks of the world. And the fourth one is the Trans-Himalaya. It is also called the Tibetan Himalayas. And this range consists of mainly Karakoram, Ladakh and Kailash range. And the fifth one is Purvanchal Hills. And this is the Northeastern Himalayas that run north to south through Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram, Tripura and Eastern Assam. Now our next subtopic is the Great Plains. And the Great Plain of India consists largely of alluvial deposits brought down by the rivers originating in the Himalayan and the peninsular region. They are mainly formed by the alluvial deposit of the Indus, Ganga, Brahmaputra and their tributaries. Now you can see in the map, Northern Plain is divided into four main divisions. It is, the first one is the Babar. The Babar belt is adjacent to the foothills of the Himalayas and consists of boulders and pebbles which have been carried down by streams. As the porosity of this belt is very high, the streams flow underground. And the second one is Tarai. The Tarai belt lies south of the adjacent Babar region and is composed of newer alluvium. And the underground streams reappear in this region. Third one is the Bhangar. The Bhangar belt consists of older alluvium and forms the alluvial terrace of the flood plains. And fourth is the Khadar. It is made up of fresh newer alluvium which is deposited by the rivers flowing down the plain. It was about the Great Plains. Now the next one is the Peninsular Plateau. These plateaus, covering an area of about 16 lakh square kilometer, forms the largest and oldest physiographic division of India. And it is bounded by the Aravallis in the northwest, Makhal Range in the north, Hazaribagh and Rajmahal Hills in the northeast, the Western Ghats in the west, and the Eastern Ghats in the east. And this peninsular plateau is divided into the Central Highland, which includes Aravalli Range, Malwa Plateau, Vindhya Range, Bundelkhand Plateau, and Bakhalkhand Plateau. And the second one is Eastern Plateau, that is Chota Nagpur Plateau and Meghalaya Plateau. And third one is Deccan Plateau, which includes Mahadev Hills, Kamur Hills, Makhal Range, Western Ghats, Nilgiri, Annamalai Hills, Palani Hills and Cardamom Hills. Eastern Ghats Mahendragiri. Maharashtra Plateau, Mahanadi Basin, Garjat Hills, Karnataka Plateau, Telangana Plateau and Tamil Nadu uplands. This was about the Peninsular Plateau. The next come is the Coastal Plains. The West Coastal Plain is a narrow coastal strip in the west facing the Arabian Sea, and the plain area between the Western Ghats and the Arabian Sea from the Gulf of Kutch and the Gulf of Khambat, located on either side of Kathiawar Peninsula, is called Gujarat Plains. The East Coastal Plain is broader and more continuous than the West Coastal Plain and lies between the Eastern Ghats and the Bay of Bengal. And a major part of the Eastern Coastal Plain is covered by the deltaic deposits of rivers Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri. It is also called Northern Sirkars between Mahanadi and Krishna rivers, and the Coromandel Coast south of the Kaveri up to the southernmost tip of the Indian mainland. Now, the next one is the Thar Desert. The Thar Desert is located in the northwest part of Aravalli Hills, also known as the Indian Desert. It is the ninth largest desert in the world, and the rainfall received is below 150 millimeter per year. And the vegetation in the Thar is semi-arid type with thorny bushes. And the rivers are ephemeral, and only Luni is a significant river. Now the last one of this chapter is about the islands. There are a number of small and large islands, and some of them are of volcanic origin while some area are of coral origin. And the first is the Lakshadweep Islands. In the Arabian Sea are a group of 36 coral islands, and they are located off the coast of Kerala. These islands are mostly flat and hardly a few meters above the sea level. And the second one is Andaman and Nicobar Islands. And it lies in the Bay of Bengal, and they are a group of 324 islands which are volcanic in nature. And Andaman Islands are separated from the Nicobar Islands by the 10 degree channel, and they are mostly rugged mountainous hills and considered submerged part of Arakoima Fold Belt. So it was about the island also. And here I have finished your chapter. Now read it once again from the book. And the work, the classwork and homework, I'll give you in the WhatsApp group. Thank you.